Hi, I'm Scotty. I service, repair and restore vintage and antique mechanical clocks. Welcome to Scotty's Clock World. Now we'll put the hands on the face, then we'll put the movement back into the case. Sit there very carefully. Our hand first. Set it at the 12 and push it down. Move that round a tiny bit. Yep. Now put the minute hand on. Also in the 12 o'clock position. And push it down. Right, now I've got to make a new taper pin, which I'll do offline because I've showed you how to do that already. And then I'll come back, we'll put it in, and then we'll put the movement into the case. That's the case with the gilding on it so far. We'll now put the back plate on it to hold the movement in. Being very careful not to upset the gold leaf. Where we go there. There they are. Drop a nut in there. Bolt in there, I mean. Lift it up, start a nut on it. Now the other side. Again. Put a nut on the back of it. And that and that. Bit big, we'll shut that down a bit. Now we'll do this one. Okay. Should now be nice and tight. We'll just check it and see. That one. Okay. There's the bar on the back. Got our movement. All the parts, there we go. Fast, slow. There's our bezel screws, three of those. See what size screwdriver we'll need. Yep, that's got him. Okay. Now, I'll put that back up on there. Now we've got one screw to go there, one to go at the back, and one to go there. So we'll put those in now. We line them up. The screws started in the thread. Part way in, not all the way. Round we go to the next one, which is there. That in. Them up, get it started. Number two, and here to the third one. We'll tighten those down now. That'll hold the movement in place. First one. Tightening down nicely. Second one. Just add a bit of an angle this one, so undo it a bit. Try them again. Ah, that's better. It's cross-threaded. There he goes. Right. Now we're ready to put it into the case. Now we'll put the movement into the case. Line it up, being very careful not to touch the gold leaf, or we're in serious trouble. Align the on off the fast slow lever there, and we'll lift it up and press it into place. Now put the screws in that hold it. We can tighten it down and pull it all in nice and tightly. This one. Right, here we go. Tighten these down with a screwdriver. We won't tighten it too tight initially, but we've got to make sure that the pendulum hangs correctly. You can see the movement working there, so that's giving us a good sign that we're in good shape. That's what the clock's looking like now. That's the cup bell. Forgot to put that on, so I'll take the movement out. I'll put the cup bell back on, and then we'll come back and pick up where we were. Okay, there's the clock all put back together again. I'll turn it round so you can see the movement working. It's up a bit higher. You can see the pendulum moving. The escape wheel. The pallet's rocking backwards and forwards on it. Right, we'll now put that aside. We'll put a digital clock beside it. We can check the time. Then once we've made adjustments to it, we'll then put the clock timing app on it and run it down as close as we can to a minute plus or minus a day. That's what we've got so far. It has another section that comes up here, and then Napoleon on a horse sits up here. This is as far as I go. George now takes over. She's got to touch up any little bits and pieces that are missed down here with gold leaf, and then put the top on, then Napoleon, and then I'll take a photo of it completely finished, and you can see what it looks like. This is the rack hook right here. That pin, when you put the gathering pallet back on before you hammer it down to keep it firm, that pin has to fall.